Hi, I'm Camille, Process Engineer at EFICAD, and today we are going to talk about SWOOD 2022 updates. Among the new features in SWOOD 2022, we'll be seeing the updates in SWOOD Nesting.
In the nesting, we will go through five key topics that are the integration of the labeling management and then the several features that will help you to get the part better held on the machine table. The panel stocks, a new way to apply a complete program strategy, and finally several improvements leading to something more user-friendly. So the labeling process is an important part of the nesting process, especially when there are CNC printers embedded. We took that into account and we can now completely manage it through the nesting module. As you can see in the video, I only need to enable these new parameters to then have access to six different options through which you can define the label position, bottom left right, top left, right, middle. The label dimension itself, the label offset, which is the gap between the part edge and the labels. And if its position is defined in regard to the complete sheets or if it's in regard to the parts. Once all the parameters are defined, you can compute the nesting optimization and I can now see all the label positions on all my nesting sheets. Obviously, we can manage them through the manual nesting. We can export them into the reports and in the programs. Talking about the manual modification, we have now two possibilities. The first one is through the manual nesting, in which I can update the position on one part and part by part. The second option is to modify it manually for all identical parts in the nesting results. To do so, we go into the nested part folder. We select the parts to modify, we check the manual labeling options, and we can now modify the label positions for all identical parts. It means that if I nest 5 times my 3D model, I will modify the label positions on the 5 parts. Now let's move on to the next feature, which is the optimal holding. Actually, optimal holding is composed of 4 different new features. These 4 new features are going to make your part better held and are going to make the nesting process much more automated. So the 4 new features that automate the nesting process are the optimization of the cutting order. So you will be able to automatically start on the smallest part to finish on the largest one. We will be able to avoid some parts from a zone that is from the board edge. We can now insert automatically bridges based on parametric rules. And the last one is the optimization of the leading and lead out position on parts. So now, how can I do that? We can do that because all the mentioned features are linked to a part type, a part category, actually. This is very simple. I'm going to define as many part type or part configuration as I want. But for this example, I will split it into 3 different categories, small, medium, and the rest. So now I can assign parts to these categories based on 2 criteria, which are the surface of the part and a dimensions. For instance, here I want that all my small parts have a maximum surface of 50,000 square millimeters. They are appearing in yellow now. Then I also want to say that if I have a long but thin part, I also want to be recognized as a small part. That is the aim of the maximum width parameter. So if you pay attention to the parts of the right-hand side of the nesting sheet and on the top left, you can see that with the maximum width at 100 mm, it is now considered as small parts. And we only need to do so to do the same for the other categories. For medium, I define it as 200,000 square millimeters, and without maximum width. And finally, the other category, in which we do not define any values, so it takes all the rest of the parts. So now, it's done. We are able to automatically categorize all our parts. So now, thanks to that, I'm going to now define different holding strategies for my categories. It means that for my small part category, I want to define an offset from the board edge of 200 millimeters. So if I had parts from the category small in this area, my nesting result will change. And you see now, that is the case. Now, the bridges. I'm going to automatically apply bridges on the part from the category small and all connected parts. And finally, the optimal lead-in and lead-out optimization. This optimization is going to find the optimum lead-in and lead-out point on each part to keep as long as possible a material connection with the main board. And that's what you are seeing in the video. You can see that I have material left on the optimized nesting sheet. Let's see it now on the SWOOD interface. I load my 3D model. I check the optimal holding options. And finally, I select which optimization I want to apply. And it's over. I only need to rebuild it, and now I have my nesting results fully optimized with all my optimal holding strategy applied. One last thing that we haven't seen during the last video is how do I configure my bridge insertions? Well, very simple. I'm going to define different states based on part edge length. Then I'm going to say, okay, if I have an edge between 500 and 1500 millimeters, I will apply the rule I'm creating. Then you define all your parametric rule in this way. So you could have three different conditions, from 50 to 200 millimeters, from 200 to 500 millimeters, and all the edges above 500 millimeters. Let's continue with the stocks. Now we have the possibility to nest all the stocks of a panel. It means that if I have a compound panel, I can specify it in the nesting, and it will automatically nest each stocks layers in the right nesting sheets. We have the example here with a panel composed of its core, top and bottom laminate that is then cut into separated boards. We also have the possibility to consider the different stock extensions. We can also work with multi-body parts and curved panel that will be automatically included and nested in all the different boards. And now the machining insertions. We have a new nesting library that allows us to define a complete program strategy at the nesting level. We have the program structure for all automatic operation, for the outline, groove, pocket, and drillings. We can reorder this by a simple drag and drop to create something that is according to your needs. So once defined, these strategies will be inserted at the nesting creation. It means it will complete the programs. So if you have machinings inserted in different parts, this one will be kept and completed with strategies defined in this new library. These strategies can be different for each post-processor. Coming to the last part of the nesting, in which we have made several interface enhancements, we have now, as SOLIDWORKS, a tooltip on all icons with the possibility to link a GIF. A new search bar has been added to the nesting board library. We switched all icons in SOLIDWORKS 10. We integrated a 3D view that lists different warnings that you might have in the nesting. We can also change the part name by an ID or a custom property value that makes something clearer, visually speaking. and you have access to these visual parameters by clicking on the nesting results sections. Now, if you have several projects loaded in the nesting, you can visually identify them with different colors. You can also enable them in the manual nesting through the eye icon in the middle of the graphic area. You can also choose and modify the part color thanks to the shortcuts if this one is shared by two different assemblies.
If you want to know more about SWOOD and our solutions, do not forget to click on the subscribe button and do not hesitate to contact us on our website, swood.efficant.com. See you soon!